Chapter 12. Dosage calculation using ratio and proportion method. In the following three chapters, we are going to discuss three different methods of dosage calculation. Method 1, ratio and proportion method. Method 2, dimensional analysis method. Method 3, formula method. Nurses should be proficient in using all three methods equally, and that's required by the nursing department, at least at BMCC. And I would recommend to learn all of them, so you will be tested on all three different methods. And what is the most important, these three methods have advantages and disadvantages. Let's look at method 1, ratio and proportion method. I'm pretty sure that this method is the most commonly used and well known for you from the arithmetic course, and we understand that usually we compare it to quantities, and if one quantity is increasing, then the second quantity is also increasing. So therefore it's also important that method of calculation for dosages in healthcare field. So nurses use the ratios either to calculate or check medication dosages. Let's go over some terminology. Ratio. Ratio is comparison of two numbers by division. We definitely want to understand that it shows how many times one quantity greater or less than another quantity. So for division, you might see colon or division bar, and they actually can be used equally. So then we read division in the formula, then we will interpret in the ratio as per, right? Or maybe two, which means comparison. So example with colon will look as 50 milligrams per 1 milliliter, or with the fraction bar, so that's already two flows there, 50 milligram to 1 milliliter. We understand and interpret that for every 1 milliliter of the specific solution, that milliliter contains of 50 milligram of medication. Proportion. Proportion is a mathematical statement, and it actually says that two ratios are equal, right? Proportional. So we have that same proportion factor. Examples of proportion. 50 milligram per one tablet. So that's one ratio equals 100 milligram per two tablets. That's the second ratio. So you see how the proportionality between numbers is changing. So we had 50 milligram, now it's 100 milligram. So we have the increase two times, and one tablet quantity increased twice again, so we have now two tablets. The same happens with 15 milligram to 4 milliliters. If 15 increased by three times, then 45 milligrams we receive for medication, and four times three, 12 milliliters for the solution. So the same you can look with the fractions. We are ready to look at a couple of examples, but before starting the examples, I would like to emphasize a couple of important points to remember. So first of all, we need to remember that all proportions, they have in the ratios two different quantities. So for each ratio, the quantities should be written in the same units. For example, milligram to milliliter, milligram to milliliter. If the terms are not in the same units, convert them. So use the conversion method which you like. Sometimes you can use just shift in the decimal point. Maybe you like method of dimensional analysis. We didn't discuss it yet, but it's really a reliable method, so hopefully you will like that. State the known ratio first if you are starting the proportions. So known ratio means available, means dosage strength which is written on the label, and then the second ratio after the equal sign, that will be item number 5 here we have on the screen, that will be unknown ratio. So and then we write the first proportion with the ratios, then please remember that what is the most important also, the units has to be in the same sequence. For example, if we write in milligrams to milliliters or per milliliter, then the second ratio has to have the same order, milligrams to milliliters. If we are mixing up the positions, then it means that we are getting not correct answer. Each answer has to be assessed. It has to be estimated, and we need to look at that if the answer is reasonable. So, ratio and proportion using colons. If you will take a look at our example in the middle on the screen, that we have the proportion 50 milligram to 1 milliliter and equals 75 milligram per x milliliter, right? So the numbers 50 milligram and x milliliters we call extremes, and the numbers in the middle 1 milliliter and 75 milligrams, they are means. So we are coming up to the first step of solving proportion, that we are using the fundamental property of proportion, that the product of means and extremes are equal. Looking at the proportion with the fractions, then in the numerator of the first ratio, the extreme is on the top and the mean is at the bottom in the denominator. In the numerator of the second ratio, the mean, the middle number, is in the numerator, and in the denominator we have the extreme. Also, please look at the positions. So the first ratio, as we discussed earlier, is known ratio, which is given as available. So both units have the numbers, and the second ratio on the right has x in the denominator, so this is unknown ratio. How do we solve proportion? Remember, we have to multiply mean by mean and extreme by extreme. We call that cross products in the proportion. So 50x equals 75. Dividing by 50 and isolating the x, we can divide 75 by 50, reducing by 25. We have 3 over 2, and 3 over 2 is 1.5 milliliters. Example number 1, ratio and proportion method. Dosage strength of medication is 70 milligram per 1 milliliter. So please take a look. That will be our known ratio. The prescriber orders 35 milligrams. How many milliliters does the nurse have to administer? Always question, do I need to administer more than 1 milliliter or less than 1 milliliter? Please take a look. 1 milliliter contains 70 milligram of medication, so you need to administer that less than 70, which means you should expect less than 1 milliliter of solution, right, to be administered. So all the time, estimate, estimate, estimate. So first of all, we need to set up our first ratio as a known ratio. So we are using the dosage strength. It's right here, 70 milligram per 1 milliliter. And the second ratio will be automatically. So we are using milligrams and milligrams in the numerators and milliliters in the denominator. That's why the second ratio will be exactly 35 milligram over x milliliters. This is the example using the colons, if you wish. So then we will cross multiply, right, guys? So we are getting 70x equals 35, and division by 70, we have 35 over 70. This example is really, really important. I'm pretty sure that we will find a couple of people who will write the answer is 2 milliliters. However, remember, we already did the estimation. Our number of milligrams is less than 70, so we should receive less than 1 milliliter. And therefore, I keep your attention here. Remember that we are reducing. It's not 70 divided by 35, it's 35 over 70. So we're reducing by 35. So we have the fraction 1 over 2, which is half of the milliliter. Example number 2, I'm offering you to pause the video and try to set up the proportion by yourself. The solution strength of 8 mg per milliliter used to prepare a dosage of 12 mg. Calculate the number of milliliters to be administered. I hope you finished your calculations and you received 1.5 milliliter as your answer. However, I want to pay attention if you set up the proportion well, and how did you simplify that? Example number 3, also please pause the video and try. Prescription for 100 milligram PO, remember it's orally, of a liquid medication available in the dosage strength of 125 milligrams per 5 milliliters. So please calculate the number of milliliters to be administered. All right, check your answer now, and your answer has to be 4 milliliters, and please double check if you simplified your proportion the same way as it's given on the screen. In example number 4, I will walk you through the ratio and proportion method with conversions needed for the problem. Prescription: 0.5 milligram of a medication and available in 200 microgram per 1 milliliter. So please take a look. Right now we have the medication given in different units. So therefore, in order to answer the question how many milliliters we need to administer, we need to make the conversion first. So here we need to break down into two steps our problem. First, we need to convert. And why we choose milligram to microgram? Because remember we discussed that usually the order has to be converted or suggested to convert to available. And if we are converting from milligram to microgram, it's from larger unit to smaller unit. We are multiplying by 1,000 and we are shifting the decimal point 3 units to the right, and that will be 500 microgram. Step 2, solve proportion. So we have 200 milligram over 1 milliliter equals 500 milligram over x milliliter. After cross multiplication, you see 200x equals 500. If you will divide both sides by 200, then you will observe that we can cross out two zeros, and 5 divided by 2 will be 2.5 milliliters.